Hi, today let's have a look on this true airspeed and static air temperature indicator. There is a part tag, removed serviceable. It seems that there are three adjustments here. There is a typical circular connector. On the front, there is a knob which permits to set this index here, and there is also a button push to test. Okay, the true airspeed is indicated by this digital mechanical display. The temperature is indicated by this pointer here. First, as usual, let's open that thing to see what is inside. It is very difficult to remove the inside assembly from the cover. There are probably several screws close to the front assembly here, because this thing seems totally stuck. It is absolutely impossible to remove that thing. What I will do, because I don't want to spend one day for that, I will cut here with the Dremel all around and I will add an adhesive after. We can see some little screws close to the front panel, but they are very difficult to access. I don't have such a long screwdriver. Okay, I cut that thing. Okay, so we have a problem here. Ah. Ah, okay, I didn't see this adhesive here. This thing is a nightmare to disassemble, but okay. We can see a mechanical limiter here, that thing here. There is a limit equals to the number of disc here, so maybe 10 turns or something like that. Okay, we can see we have two motors, one for the true air speed here. Second one for the static air temperature. Okay, we can see here a potentiometer. And there is another one. Probably this is a dual potentiometer. This is maybe a synchro transmitter which permits to have a copy of the measurement. So we can see that these three screws should be removed to remove the complete assembly. We need a long tool for that. Okay, so we can see here two servo amplifiers. They are identical normally. This is the power supply board. You can see a bridge rectifier. the power supply transformer. This is an inductor. So we can see here there is a transistor with 4 pins. This is probably a JFET. This amplifier uses 4 transistors. One, this JFET, and 3 bipolar transistors. So let's see the part number. There is a 2N336. And here there are 2 transistors, 1 relay, and a few passive parts. You can see the trimmers here. The transistors are maybe used for the power supply. There is a 2N2197. Second one is the same. I don't know if the inputs of this instrument are DC voltages or AC voltages. I need an instrument which works with DC voltages. I hope it is the case. In that case, maybe this JFET is used to convert a DC raw voltage into an AC raw voltage, but I am not sure. So I think the best thing to do is to do the reverse engineering of one servo amplifier. It is not very complicated. I did the complete reverse engineering of this instrument. You can see on that page the schematic of one servo amplifier. The input is here. So we can see this 4-pin transistor. Actually, it is not a JFET. It is a particular transistor. The reference is here. It is a very obscure reference, 5618T631. I didn't find anything on internet regarding this reference. But we can see that this transistor is connected between the input and the ground, and the 2 other pins here are connected to 1 secondary of a transformer. So this is a signal at 400 Hz. So obviously this transistor is used as a switch. So this permits to convert the DC raw voltage into an AC raw voltage. I have represented also inside the symbol here the different junctions. It is something similar to a Darlington, but of course it is not a Darlington. So I don't know exactly what is this kind of transistor. It is not something common. This amplifier has actually 4 stages. There is the first amplification here using this NPN transistor. The second one, there is a local feedback here using this capacitor and this resistor. And there is another stage using this PNP transistor. So the gain is quite high, but there is the feedback here from that pin to the input pin. The total gain is negative because we have 3 transistors in cascade here. This signal is fed to the power stage, which is this transistor, which is located on the power supply board. This transistor is polarized using these 2 diodes in series here and these 2 resistors. The drive winding of the motor is connected in parallel to this capacitor. This capacitor permits to tune the circuit to 400 Hz. It uses the inductance of the drive winding of the motor. You can see on that page the complete schematics. We have the 2 servo control amplifiers here. This one for the static at temperature, and on the bottom of this page, a second one for the true airspeed. The schematic diagram is more or less identical for both indications. Let's have a look first on the static air temperature circuit. The error voltage is here. This is the DC error voltage. So we can see that the output is connected to the command winding of the motor. The reference winding is here. There is a capacitor in series in order to have 90 degrees phase shift. The input here is the middle point of this arrangement of resistors. So we can see that we have 2 main inputs, this one and this one. So the goal is to have 0 volt in the middle here. So obviously, one is the reference voltage and the second one the input voltage. And also it is obvious that 1 voltage should be negative. For example, if the input voltage is here, the second one is the reference voltage, which should be negative. The feedback potential meter is here. Actually, it is used as a variable resistor. There is one trimmer here. We can see here a contact of a relay. So the relay is activated actually by the test button here. So when the test button is pressed, voltage here is applied to that site. This permits to have a modification of the indication here. This is the circuit for the true airspeed. You can see it is more or less identical. There is a positive voltage here and a negative one here. The feedback potentiometer is here. It is linked to the motor through a gear train. There are two trimmers for the true airspeed. One is here and the second one here. You can see that there is also a potentiometer here which is linked to the static air temperature. Okay, so there is a correction of the true airspeed according to the static air temperature. This indicator is intended to be used with a specific air data computer. Obviously, it is not compatible anyway to the standard ERINC 565. In the standard 565, there is a positive reference voltage and also a positive input voltage. So it is not compatible with this instrument. In the standard, you don't need this dependency between the true airspeed and the static air temperature. So we can see that there is also a synchro transmitter which is linked to the output shaft here. Therefore, it is possible also to connect a passive indicator for the true airspeed. And this one, for example, on this instrument, the pointer is directly attached to the synchro. As I don't want to buy and to test dozens of instruments, I will use this one for the connection to the data computer compliant with ERINC 565. For that purpose, I will need an interface at the input which permits to have a negative reference voltage and probably to modify the input function. And also, I will need to neutralize this potentiometer. So I will short-circuit this potentiometer in order to have the true airspeed independent of the temperature.